Hello students, in today's session we will discuss one more problem on the cantilever beam where we trying to solve slope and deflection of our beam, right? We trying to analyze where will be the maximum slope occurs, where will be the maximum deflection occur, and also in the last few sessions we are going with the different types of beams, simply supported beam, cantilever beam. Now we are dealing with from this beams which we have solved so far, we have observed that boundary condition plays a vital role, or if the support conditions changes, the boundary condition changes and our whole analysis differs. Okay, if I am dealing with the simply supported beams, the boundary condition tells that maximum slope will be zero, then the deflection will be maximum, or rather I will say a maximum deflection occur where slope is zero. Whereas if we see same condition to the cantilever beam, it changes, right? Where there is a maximum slope, even this deflection is maximum. I mean, in the simply supported beam, slope will be zero, deflection will be maximum. In the cantilever beam, slope and deflection both will be maximum at a particular point. Okay, if we speak specifically in the cantilever beam at free end, where the free movement is allowed, at that point slope also gets maximum value and deflection also develops maximum value. Why? Because it is free to deflect or free to move from its place, right? So boundary conditions, it means the support condition plays a vital role. Now we already solved few problems in the last two sessions. Those problems were for the cantilevers. If we see, those were for the variable loads. Variable loads means I have applied a W load on my beam, which can be a uniformly distributed or can be a concentrated load. But why am I saying it's variable? Because W can be a 10 kilonewton, 5 kilonewton, 0 kilonewton, or W can be a 100 and 200 kilonewton. It can be depends on your choice of loading. Therefore, I said I have applied a variable loads on my beam and analyzed it. But if I apply a constant loads, how I will deal with the such a beams, that I'm gonna see to that I'm gonna teach you today. Yes, so see here, I have wrote one problem on my screen. You can check here. Determine deflection at B, C and D for a cantilever beam loaded as shown in a figure. Figure is given here. Using Macaulay's method, you have to use Macaulay's method here, and using Macaulay's method you analyze slope and deflection for the given beam. Take E is equals to 2 into 10 to the power 5 and I is given as 2 into 10 to the power 8 mm raised to 4. Okay, so both are the units in mm. You can directly calculate E into I. Okay, if we see loading conditions on my beam is simply cantilever beam. One end is fixed, other end is free at this place. On the free end, we have applied a 10 kilonewton load and 10 kilonewton uniformly distributed load also for 3 meter span, and one more point load of 20 kilonewton is acting across my beam. Now for this beam, if I design, if I try to find a slope and deflection, I have to develop a slope deflection equations, right, which we gonna double integrate in the further steps. So let's go, let's try to find a solution for this. I have calculated EI, I have calculated EI 2 into 10 to the power 3 and 2 into 10 to the power 8. Sorry, 2 into 10 to the power 5 and 2 into 10 to the power 8. I have multiplied that and I calculated EI, which is a flexural rigidity, right? Which we need, combinedly we need a EI in our further calculation. There we will place directly, or there we will put directly the value to, 40 into 10 to the power 3 kilonewton per meter square. So we have converted mm into meter. Be careful at it. Okay. Now first equation is moment equation about a x axis. For that we need a diagram. Yes, you can see like this. First it is, I have started, I have taken a x distance. Where I have taken x distance? Now in the cantilever beam, you must remember, in the cantilever beam we always take a x distance from free end. You should not remember, for the cantilever beam we always take a x distance from its free end. Okay, therefore I have shown here the x distance from the free end, and I have taken a x section at fixed end. Right, now how I will develop my moment equation? See here, minus 10. Now why minus 10? It is clockwise. You can see it is making a clockwise moment. Still I am taking a negative, because see, the rules for the sign conventions here are, from, if you are moving from left hand side, moment which is making clockwise moment, a force which is making a clockwise moment will be taken positive. But if we moving from right hand side, then if we moving from right hand side, then the moment which is creating clockwise, which is rotating in a clockwise direction, that we will consider negative. So that is the difference. If we moving towards right, or if you are moving from the left, or you are moving from the right, or from left hand side and from right hand side, the sign conventions are exactly opposite. Therefore, in my calculation, you can see here minus 10, 10 into x. Now x is a total distance, horizontal distance, right? Then minus 20 into this total x minus 2 meter. So x minus 2 meter. Next is this 10 into this distance. You have to minus this distance from your total x. So 10 into x minus this 2 plus 2. How much? 4. Therefore, x minus 4 whole square divided by 2. Why? Because it is uniformly distributed load. Uniformly distributed load, how you convert it first of all into point load and then multiply it with its horizontal distance. That's why our equation became like this. Okay. Next is double integration. Integrate it first. Write down the constants. Do not forget to write down the constants. First integration will be ei d square y by dx square. If you integrate this term, you will get dy by dx, and if you integrate dy by dx, you will get y. Okay, so left hand side is clear. We see towards right hand side. Minus 10 into x will be minus 10 into x square divided by 2 plus c1. Do not forget, you always write a constant in the first compartment of your equation, right? The next is yours. Okay, minus 20 into x minus 2 whole square divided by 2. Okay, next is minus 10 divided by 2. I have taken on the left hand side, and on right hand side I remain with the x minus 4, that will turn into x cube, or x minus 4 cube divided by 3. So this is how we integrated our terms. Once you integrate the second equation, you integrate it one more time. I'll take this on this side. Okay, so integrate it one more time, in which integration will be for slope equation. This is your slope equation. Integrate the slope equation. You will develop a deflection equation. Rest of the integration part is, I hope you are habitual to now. I will not explain it. Better we will go for the boundary conditions. Now see, I have told you frequently that boundary conditions depends upon the support conditions. What are the support conditions? Accordingly, our boundary conditions are set or developed. See, in my beam, one end is fixed and other end is free. One end is fixed, which is which is why we said our beam is cantilever, one end is fixed, one end is free to move, right? Now, when my x is a total travels a total distance of 7 meter, my dy by dx slope at this point, dy by dx will be 0. Why? Because my fixed end will not allow any kind of movement at that point, right? Therefore, slope as well as deflection at that point of a 7 meter distance, deflection as well as slope became 0. That are the my two boundary conditions. When my x travel a total length of a beam at fixed end, slope as well as deflection became 0, right? So apply those boundary conditions. First, when you say slope equals to 0, apply it in equation 2, because equation 2 talks about the slope of my beam. Then when you come to the deflection boundary condition, where you say deflection is 0, you apply the this boundary conditions or substitute these values in equation 3, okay? Understood? Put the first boundary condition in slope equation, substitute the second boundary condition for equation number 3, and calculate the constant C1 and C2. I got C1 value equals to 540 and C2 value, which is minus 2757.91. Okay, now one more thing which I want to remind you is that whenever you are using equations for slope and equation for the deflection, you must remember that you are using complete equation of a slope and complete equation of a deflection. Why complete equation? Because you are applying a boundary condition for a cantilever beam in which you have covered the total x distance. You have traveled the total x distance. That's why x became 7 meter. And we have developed our equations from the free end. Therefore, we should cover each and every term and reach to the fixed end. That's why when I am calculating C1, I am trying to calculate the constant, that time I am using total equation of slope as well as deflection. No doubt now? I hope you are clear. Rest of the things is just put the x equals to 7 in the equation and calculate the constants. I hope you are good with the calculations. Now, general equations. In the next step, I have wrote general equations. What does it mean? I have wrote I have substituted my C1 and C2 values, my constant values, into my calculations, into my equation. When I place my C1 and C2 values in my calculations or in my equations, that time I will say general equation for slope and deflection. So I have wrote here deflection equation. Now I want to calculate deflection at B, C and D point. They have asked in the question C. In the question they have asked for B, C and D point. And they have not asked slope, they only asked about the deflection. So let's go one by one. We will first calculate slope at B. Slope at B, x will be 4, because see, this is your cantilever beam. You started from this end and x has traveled certain distance to reach B point, that is 4 meter. You can check in the diagram. Come here. Yes, at B point, x will be 4 meter. At C point, x will be 2 meter, and at D point x will be 0. Okay, x will be 2 meter at C, at B x will be 4 meter, and at D x will be 0. Put the conditions in the slope equation. I have placed x equals to 4, x equals to 0. Right, now when I said x equals to 4, you should use your slope deflection equation till the 4 meter distance, till the 4 meter distance. When I am using x equals to 0, you should use only first compartment of your equation. But in the case of above, when x is a 4, you should use the terms till the 4 meter has crossed. You should not take the terms beyond 4 meter like this. If you see, this is your general slope equation. Here you have number of terms, but you can't use this terms and beyond, because till this 4 minus 3 will gives you a value. Beyond this, you crossed a 4 meter distance, you are moving towards 5 meter. That's why you cannot take those into calculation. When x you have set 0, you will consider only the first compartment of your b, only the first compartment, because this first compartment is at x equals to 0, is wrote for x equals to 0. Do not forget first compartment along with your constant. So that's how we have calculated deflections at two different points, at B and at C. At D one more point is remaining, that I am giving you as a homework. You try to analyze it at your end, okay? Now let's try to solve one more problem of a cantilever beam. Here the question says calculate theta. Okay, now they have asked us a slope as well as deflection. Calculate the slope theta b and deflection y b for a cantilever beam loaded at shown in figure. So figure is given with us, and E is given 200 GPa, I is given 5 into 10 to the power 8 mm raised to 4. So convert it, calculate the flexural rigidity. E into I, kilonewton per mm square and kilonewton per meter square. So you should take care of units of your E and I. Unit should be in a, if you are taking E into mm, I should be in a mm. I hope you are good with the unit convergence. Every time we will not spend so much of time on it. I would like you to do this at your home, exercise it. Next is developing a moment equation. So what is the change in this type of a beam? Here you have a UDL across your beam, but it is situated somewhere in this region. Only in that region you have a UDL. Now I have told you in the simply supported beam, if you are taking a x from this end, the continuity of load should be maintained in the other end. Continuity should be maintained. If you are applying a uniformly distributed load, it should be continue till the other end. Then and then only your x distance will be valid. Okay, that's why the new thing in this problem is, if the load is applied only for this region, you have taken an extra load and you have balanced it with the dummy load from the bottom side. Right, and then we will try to analyze this beam. Okay, let's develop a moment equation. That is a new part. Here the moment equation says, consider a section xx, they are talking about this xx distance, at a x distance from free end B, applying a downward and upward UDL of 20 kilonewton per meter of a same intensity. You have applied a uniformly distributed load in the downward and in upward direction so that they get balanced to each other, they get nullified to each other. This is you applied over a span of A to C. From A to C you have applied it of a same intensity, 20 kilonewton in the downward and upward direction. And now we will try to develop a moment equation. Moment equation will be mx equals to ei d square y dx square equals to minus 40 kilonewton, 40 into x, minus 40 into x. Now again, moment is a clockwise, but we are moving from the right hand side, and from the right hand side, clockwise moment will be negative and anti-clockwise moment will be positive. Remember this. Minus 40 into x minus 20 into x by 2. Minus 20 into x by 2 is for this span of a UDL. 20 is the intensity of it. X into x by 2 will be converting into point load and then multiplying it with its distance. Right, then it is also making anti-clockwise movement, that's why clockwise movement, that's why taken negative over here. Next is, you will consider next, in the next part you will consider upward force, you will not consider downward directive force. Okay, you will consider upward force at this place, and that is making, upward force is making anti-clockwise movement while traveling towards the xx section, and that's why I have taken it positive. Okay, that's why I have taken it positive. And this 20 into, this 20 into what will be the minus? This 2 meter, x minus 2 into x minus 2 divide by 2, that will be your total equation for moment. Right, now you should make a note of two points over here. Very first note point is, you should consider always a dummy force to continue our UDL if you are taking a x from free end. Your UDL should be uniform till the end. Okay, and while calculating, you will only consider the upward intensity or upward applied loading while calculations. Okay, you will not consider the downward applied UDL. Right, now integration, integrated twice, you will get, by the integration you will get first equation as integration of d square y by dx square will be dy by dx minus 40 into x square by 2 plus c1, do not forget integration constant, minus 20 into x square by 3, and 2 I have taken below or in the denominator of 20. Rest of the things you know, actually you integrate one more time, do not forget the integration constant c2 while integrating it twice. Okay, now once you integrate, next is a boundary conditions. Now here rest of the story will be same. You are applying a boundary conditions for what? Cantilever beam, right? For the cantilever beam, what will be the boundary condition? At fixed end, you have started x from the free end, that is again a important thing, x, you have started from the free end. X will travel a total distance L dy by dx, as well as y will be 0, right? Apply that boundary conditions and use the total equation of a slope as well as complete equation of deflection, because we are writing the equation for total distance of x. Here the total distance of x is 4 meter. You put it into the dy equation first, use the complete equation and calculate the c1 value. In the next part, you will apply x equals to 4 and y equals to 0 for the deflection equation. You will put this constants in deflection equation and see here y is 0 and at place of x you are putting x equals to 4 meter and calculate c2 value once you got c1 and c2 values, yes, here once you get c1 and c2 values, you should put they have asked us a deflection at free end and also they have asked slope at free end. They have asked slope at free end and deflection at free end. Why? Because we know that slope and deflection will has a maximum value at the free end of your cantilever, right? Therefore x is equals to 0 for the slope equation. Put x equals to 0 in that, you will get theta equals to constant c1, because see, you have a slope equation here. Yes, right, you have a slope equation here. in this equation, if you put the x value equals to 0, what will be? This will get 0, this one becomes 0, this one also becomes 0. Actually, you apply only for the first compartment because you are writing or you are solving only for the x equals to 0, right? In the slope equation also, you use compartment first compartment only because you are writing or you are using equation for x equals to 0. So this will become 0, c1 into x becomes 0, what remains is c2. Here also what remains is c1. So in dy by dx, c1 will be your value of slope and in deflection, c2 will be your value of deflection. I hope you are getting it. Yes. Here, c1 is giving you a slope, as I said, and y2 deflection is given by c2. Okay, we got the value of slope as 5.07 into 10 to the power 3 radian, and deflection is minus 14 mm, which is downward in direction. Right now, whatever I have explained over here, you are supposed to write it down in your book. You try to solve it on your own, exercise it, practice it on your own until and unless you don't develop the equation, until and unless you don't practice yourself, you will not get this subject. So I always request you, carry your notebooks while watching this videos and write it down, whatever I am telling, write it down in your book. And after the finishing class, once you understand and absorb the few things from this session, you solve similar type of problem, one more similar type of problem. It will take hardly a 6 to 7 minutes to solve such a type of problem, okay, along with your calcium, and then only you will get a better idea of this subject or of this slope deflection method. Okay, now here we have done with the cantilever beams as well as the simply supported beam. In the next class, I will solve one more problem which has a couple on it. Okay, it is simply supported beam or it can be a cantilever beam but has a couple loading upon it which we have not yet seen. So we will try that problem in the next class and then we will go for the B part of your session or B part of your unit where we are dealing with the Clausthenes-Lanois theorem. So what is Clausthenes-Lanois theorem? You revised or you try to read few concepts from the book if you have. Otherwise, we will deal it in the next class. Thank you.